Welcome to video 10 in the CCT Data Center course. In this video, we are going to discuss fiber optics and connectors. The topics we're going to cover in this video include fiber cables, different fiber modes, different fiber types. We're going to look at the fiber connectors and fiber optics themselves just a little bit. All right, fiber cables. The first thing we're going to talk about is the picture down at the bottom. Now, I know this is really basic, but the main thing that I want to illustrate here is that with a fiber cable, it's not just like an Ethernet cable. Being a guy who hasn't come from an extensive data center background, I know that when I first started looking at fiber optics, I wanted it to be just as simple as an Ethernet cable that you just plug in and it just works. But there's actually a number of variables when it comes to fiber optics. There's a lot of details and there's definitely a lot of ways to screw it up. So what I have down here is a picture of the different elements of, like, let's say you're going to connect two Nexus switches. That's what we have here. On the left and the right, we have the icons for Nexus switches. Then there's an optic that is plugged into the Nexus switches, which connects to a specific connector type that is connected to the cable. And then on each side, you have that. You have the connector connecting to the optic, and then the optic going into the Nexus switch. So all of these elements must be compatible with each other. The optic must be compatible. The optic that you're plugging directly into the Nexus switch must be compatible. The connector fits a specific type of optic. So the optics that you order from Cisco have to match the connector type that is going to be on the cable. And then the cable itself also comes down. There's also decisions to be made with the cable itself. So the main point that I just want to get across is that there's these three elements that you have to understand and know if you're going to be putting together a solution with fiber optic cables. All right, so let's address the length bullet here. So the length for fiber optics is always specified in meters. And the length is really the first variable that you ask. If you were going to put together a fiber run, how long is the run going to be? That's going to determine the mode and fiber type. And we're actually going to look at a lot of that later. In the optics lesson, we're going to go to the Cisco data sheets and we're going to look at how you would break it all down and really put everything together. And then this physical components bullet is what we just went through. More on fiber cables. Fiber mode. So there's two different modes. You have multimode, which is used for shorter distances, and then single mode, which is used for longer distances. And then the different fiber types are just going to be OM1, OM2, OM3, OM4, and OM5. OM1 and OM2 are largely deprecated standards. If new fiber runs are being put in, you'd want to make sure that it's at least going to be OM3. Here's a graphic that I found that illustrates the different fiber types when they were released. You can see that the very first OM1 is really old. It's actually a very old standard. It was released in 1989. And then the other ones, OM3 is still a valid fiber type, which was introduced in 2002. So it's had a pretty extensive life. Fiber modes. So here are some graphics that illustrate the differences between multi-mode and single mode. If you look at the top graphic, for the OM1 standard, you can see that it has a very large core. And then for the other OM standards, it still has a large core, but it's a little bit smaller. And the general principle of multi-mode fiber is that you can have multiple streams at once and they bounce off of the sides. So the reason that multi-mode fiber is better for, or only works for shorter distances, is because every time the light reflects off the sides, the signal becomes degraded a little bit. And in order for it to go long distances, like the single mode fiber, you can't have it bouncing off the sides. That's how it's able to go, you know, up to 40 or 50 kilometers. But then also note that the core in the middle of the single mode fiber is much, much smaller. All right, now we're gonna look at fiber connectors. One thing to note is that the most common, and there's a lot of different fiber types, that's why I'm making this designation, is that the most common is going to be the LC, the MPO, the ST, and the SC standards. Another thing to note is that these fiber cables can be either duplex, simplex, or the MPO type. Duplex is going to be bidirectional. There's actually going to be two channels in the cable. Simplex is just going to be one channel, meaning that you can only go in one direction at a time. And the MPO type is actually 12 individual wires. And you'll still see this is pretty common, but it's a very different type of fiber cable than the other ones that you'll see most commonly. Here is a collage of fiber connectors. If you look on the far left, here's the LC connectors. These are going to be the most common ones. With the customers that I work with, like 99% of what we work with is going to be these LC connectors. And you'll see the two heads on here. This is an example of a duplex connector. Then this one right here under MPO, this is the MPO connector. If you look right here, you can see the 12 different wires. And then here we have a table of all the other connector types. And these would be examples of simplex, right? So here you see you have the LC connectors again, but there's only one of them. That means it's a simplex connection. Then these ones down here at the bottom, again, these are going to be the most common ones, which include the LC, Verlucent connector, subscriber connector, and straight tip connector. All right, and here's a collection of the optics. Again, so these are the modules that the fiber connectors plug into. So the optics modules and the fiber connectors have to be compatible with each other. And we're going to be going into these a lot more in future lessons when we do this. I just wanted to include these in here and show you what they look like. All right, that wraps up fiber optics and connectors. The topics covered in this video included fiber cables, the different fiber modes, the different fiber types. We looked at some fiber connectors and a little bit at the optical modules themselves. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe, and I'll see everyone in the next one.